Hey everyone, it's Spy Cat. We're on to another one of my favorite actresses who I collect, Sissy Spacek. Sissy Spacek was actually born on the day of Christmas, December 25th, 1949, which makes her 66 years old, and she's from Texas. So I'm going to show you guys my Sissy Spacek movie collection. I'm sure I have over like close to 25 or more movies with her in it. And I'm going to show you guys starting from the earliest movie that she was in to the latest movie that I have with her in it. So here we go, my Sissy Spacek movie collection. All right, and start this thing off. What other movie could I start this Sissy Spacek movie collection than Carrie? Stephen King's Carrie. This movie is such a great movie. They've tried to redo it, but it does not even come close to comparing with this original one from 76 with John Travolta. This is just a great movie. I've always loved this movie ever since I saw it when I was a kid. It's just a great movie. And I have two editions of the movie. I have the Carrie one with the original cover right there with her in the fire, which is an awesome cover. This is the special edition right there. I love this one. It actually has a bunch of like special features even on the first release that came out, which was this one. And then I have this one that I haven't opened yet. It's this limited edition collectible card with exclusive artwork. I guess the card's like in the DVD, but this is a pretty cool artwork on this thing. It's a DVD. I still would want to get this movie on Blu-ray, but I just haven't seen it in my price range to get it yet. But yeah, this is a pretty cool edition. Not going to open this one either. It's just kind of for the collection kind of thing. But yeah, Carrie, 1976. And then 5 years after that, she was in a movie called Raggedy Ann with Sam Shepard and Eric Roberts. I haven't watched this one. I bought it. I haven't in my collection, but I haven't actually watched this one. Couldn't tell you much about this one. If you guys want to always pause and read what this thing's about, go ahead. Feel free to. I'm not going to read it out loud because I have a lot of Sissy Spacek movies to go through. Next movie I have, this is a good movie. I like this one. You guys all know, if you don't know this by now, Jack Lemmon is one of my favorite all-time actors of all time. So, yeah, Missing with Jack Lemmon. And Missing came out a year after that in 1982. And if you guys wanted to pause and read what this one's about, go ahead. Because I haven't seen this in a while, but I remember it's a good one. Good action kind of suspense thriller movie. And rated PG. So even the kids can watch it. But that was PG in the early 80s, though. So it was kind of PG-13, kind of R, you know, some of those movies back then. But she was also in The Man with Two Brains, which came out a year after that, in the year I was born, 1983. And she plays the role of Anne. She does the voice on this movie. She's not in it. She just does the voice of Anne. And this is a pretty cool snapback cover here with Steve Martin. Awesomeness going on there. And this one is a good one. You guys know me. I love my adventure movies. Love the movies where people are like in the... It's like man versus wild. I love movies like that. And that's why I absolutely love the River movie. This movie's just awesome. Super awesome, man. And the River came out a year after that in 1984 with Mel Gibson. If you guys want to read what this one's about. Scott Glenn's in this too. But yeah, you guys can read what it's about. Try to focus a little bit more for you. But yeah, I'm glad I have this one in my collection. This is a good one. And then a year after that, in 1985, she was in a movie called Marie, which is about a prison, which is pretty crazy. It's based on a true story. I got this big old super humongous old school MGM box tape thing going on here, which is pretty crazy. I actually used to hide money under these things because you used to be able to take this thing out and you could hide stuff in there back in the day. But yeah, this movie's great. Not a lot of people know about this movie. I have yet to see this movie whenever I go to the store. I don't see it on DVD or Blu-ray. So this might be kind of... I might be pretty lucky that I have this tape because I haven't seen this on DVD. Yeah, if you haven't seen Marie, go ahead and watch that because it's a great movie. You guys can always pause and read what the movie's about. She's standing up to a corrupt jail system, which is, I always love movies like that. Next movie I have is Night Mother with Anne something, Bancorf? Not even going to try and say that, whatever. But another movie that I only have the VHS copy of. And this movie came out a year after that in 1986, rated PG-13. You guys wanted to read what this one's about, go ahead. But I just got this tape because I never see this movie on DVD, and I just grabbed it. It's Sissy Spacek. Ooh, whoa. I'm reading it kind of through the phone, and it looks pretty good. In a trod emotional study about a mother's attempt to stop her distraught daughter from committing suicide. Wow. This looks like a good movie, man. Same as Marie. I never saw this on DVD or Blu-ray, so it's kind of cool that I actually had this old-school Sissy Spacek movie for the Sissy Spacek movie collection. And the next movie I have is from the director of Drive-In Miss Daisy, which was an outstanding movie. Loved that movie. And it's also out of print. I remember I paid... I forgot, but I could have sworn I paid like $29-$30 for this one used. And I don't know if it's out of print anymore, but this movie used to go for a lot of money, even used. And it's Crimes of the Heart with Jessica Lange and Diane Keaton. And this movie also came out in 1986. Nominated for 3 Academy Awards and based on the acclaimed play, 3 Southern sisters come together for the most unlikely reunion in this tale of family loyalty and ultimate sibling rivalry. Looks pretty good to me. I gotta watch this one. Oh, see, that's why Trinity, this company probably is out of print. That's why you don't see this movie too much, I guess. And it's out of print. Pretty cool. Always love collecting those out of print ones, and Sissy Spacek out of print. Can't beat it. And the next movie I have, this movie is a pretty well-known Sissy Spacek movie, and it's called The Long Walk Home. This one came out 4 years after Crimes of the Heart in 1986, so this one came out in 1990. Whoopi Goldberg's in it. She has, like, a good role in this movie. This is kind of what made her kind of famous, too. Great movie, man. I love this movie. And I have the old-school VHS tape just because I'm a fan of that original cover and all. I remember seeing this when I was a kid, and it was really... really a violent movie, really, even though it's PG, you know, it has to do with, like, the time of, like, when they were all racist and stuff like that, so it's kind of a crazy movie, really a racist movie, hateful guy right there, you can obviously see that, but this is a great movie, one of my favorite, Sissy Spacek movies for sure, besides, like, Carrie. Yeah, Carrie, Long Walk Home, The River, those are my favorite ones so far, but we're going to keep going. And I also have the DVD of this, which I don't like the cover of this DVD. It's really dark. It's like all you see is, wow, that's, I don't like this cover. That's just me. Oh, wow, and they really did a great job on the back. Wow, that took a lot of time there. Oh, yeah, because, of course, it's platinum one. I wonder if they have another release of this one on DVD or Blu-ray. I'm going to have to look into that and maybe get that. Because I got the cheap old platinum DVD version of this one. And a year after that, in 1991, she was in the movie, Oliver Stone's movie called JFK. I got the director's cut, which is pretty cool. Kevin Costner's in this. A lot of famous actors are in this one. And she plays the character of Liz Garrison. And this is a really cool set going on here. I like this one a lot. This is a good movie. And the next movie I have is another one of those movies that I really have a hard time finding on DVD. I don't know if it was ever even released on DVD, but I'm glad that I have the rare VHS copy of Trading Moms, which came out a couple years after that in 1994. And Anna Chlumsky's in it. We all know her from My Girl movies. This is just a great movie. I remember this when I was a kid. I rented it when I was a kid, watched it when I was a kid, and this is a good movie, man. I got to rewatch this one and kind of give myself some old flashback memories of watching this when I was a kid, because this was a good one, man. Great movie. I loved this when I was a kid. And they trade moms in it, you know what I mean? So it's just, you know, any kid would love this movie. They don't make any good movies like these anymore, you know? Not like the old 90s movies, especially early 90s. This, really glad I have this one in my collection, because this one's hard to find. And a year after that, in 1995, she was in the movie called The Grass Harp, which is, you know, I gotta say, Walter Matthau and Jack Lemmon are my favorite all-time actors. Burt Lancaster, Clint Eastwood, John Wayne. There's a bunch more I'm forgetting, but these are like the main, like, five. Definitely Walter Matthau, Jack Lemmon. I have to have every single one of their movies in my collection. I just always love them. And I'm gonna be honest, I mean, judging by just the cover, you could pretty much tell that this is a boring movie. It is. I never even took the time to watch it or try to watch it, but it just looked, just from the cover, it just looked really boring. I mean, one of these days, I'm definitely going to have to give this one a try, but I haven't yet. And if you guys always want to pause and read what this one's about, you can go ahead. Oh, and the guy from Terminator's in there, Edward Furlong. He has a little role in this movie, too. I will be doing his my movies of him, too, real soon. I don't know when. I have so many actors I have to get through for this actor series that I'm doing. Blast from the Past, she plays the mother of Brandon Fraser when they locked themselves in the bomb shelter for, like, 25 years. And then they come up and everything's changed. It's like the future, but it's like, you know, Blast from the Past, man. This right here is one of my favorite movies of all time. This is one of those movies you can watch over and over again. Just the whole story, the whole plot. It's just, I love this movie. This is just one of my favorite movies of all time. And this one came out in 1999. I saw this movie actually in school, and I loved it, man. I can't tell you how much I love this movie, man. Or no, it says 35 years they were in the bomb shelter. My mistake, I said 25 years. But this is just such a great movie, man. Sissy Spacek's so cool, man. She's just awesome. Awesome actress, man. And Blast from the Past is definitely one of my favorite Sissy Spacek movies. Although I will say she doesn't have, like, a big part in it. She's in it a lot, but she's not, like... It's mainly Alicia Silverstone and Brandon Fraser. But next movie I have for you guys is Walt Disney's The Straight Story, which came out also in 1999, won a couple of awards. Best Actor, Richard Farnsworth, Academy nominee, based on a true story, it says. If you guys always want to read exactly what it's about, just press pause and you can read what this crap's about. Next movie I have that she was in was another Walt Disney movie, and this movie is Tuck Everlasting, which came out couple years after that in 2002. I think I got this like in the dollar bin or somewhere. But yeah, if you guys want to pause and read what this one's about. Looks like I haven't watched this one actually. I gotta watch this one. Maybe I watched it when I was a kid, like the story. But because I know there's another... I know this is based on a old story. I don't think 2002 was the first... to come out with Tuck Everlasting. I could have sworn I've heard this story before. Haven't watched a movie, though. And 2 years after that, in 2004, she was in this movie called A Home at the End of the World with Colin Farrell. She has a little part in it. She's like the last credited on the cover. I'm sure they just put that just to say she's in it. I don't think she has a big part in this movie, but... You guys can always read what this one's about. It's kind of a drama movie. And the next movie I have, she was in The Ring 2. And she plays the character Evelyn. This one came out in 2005, a year after Home at the End of the Road. And this is the unrated edition right here. And judging by the hole on the bottom of this thing, it was an old blockbuster movie. And the next movie I have is one of my favorite movies. You guys saw this movie when I did my Charlize Theron movie collection, North Country, Which is, man, one of my favorite movies of all time. How there's only a few girls working in this steel mill, and the guys end up being really mean. They're bullying the women. The few women that work there, they treat them like garbage, and they just are. It's based on a true story of how they're just really mean to the women that work in this place. They're playing tricks on them, assaulting them, sexually harassing them. It's really a messed up movie. Really a good movie. This one should have won an Academy Award. And this one came out a couple years after Charlize Theron's Monster, which was another great movie in 2003. And then a couple years after that, she did it again in North Country. Great movie, man. I absolutely love this movie. One of my favorites of all time. And the next movie I have is An American Haunting. Freaky movie, man. This movie right here came out in 2005. And it is... Oh, no. You know what? North Country came out in 2005. I said 2006. And this is another 2005 movie, An American Haunting, which I have the unrated edition. This movie I've watched a lot of times. This is definitely one of the scariest movies, the scariest horror movies I can think of. Just, it's up there with The Ring and The Grudge movies. Man, and a couple of those Exorcists of Emily Rose. All these movies kind of came out around the same time, and this one is really, really crazy. I remember, I think Donald Sutherland, is that Donald? Yeah. Yeah, Donald Sutherland, like, takes away this lady's land. She can't make the payments on the house, and then when she takes away the land away from this woman, the woman who Donald Sutherland takes away the land happens to be a witch, and she lays this curse on Donald Sutherland's whole family, gets this curse, and it ends up affecting his daughter. And it is just a crazy, scary movie. Yeah, so you might want to watch this with somebody if you haven't watched this before, because it will scare the crap out of you. Might give you a little bit of nightmares, too. And that was 2005. Then 2 years after that, she was in this movie in 2007 called Pictures of Hollis Woods, which is one of those Hallmark Hall of Fame movies. I look at these just like the Lifetime movies. They're mainly like family, I wouldn't say chick flicks, but like, there's not many men I know that are probably watching the Lifetime movies and the Hallmark movies. I personally like them. I love them. They have a good message to them. They have a good, like, good spirit, good message movie. That's why I like the Hallmark and the Lifetime movies. But I haven't watched this one yet. I need to watch this one. Ooh, and it looks like miracles still happen. This movie's going to be cool, man. I like this movie. And you guys can read what this is about. Let me just focus. Confused about everyday tasks. Yeah, this looks like a cool movie. One of those good drama TV movies. Hallmark Channel movies. That was 2007, another movie that also came out. No, this one came out a year later in 2008. She was in this movie called Four Christmases, where this is basically about Reese Witherspoon and Vince Vaughn. They go to four different Christmases because I think both of his parents are separated and both of her parents might be separated. So they have to go to like two different Christmas dinners with her family and two over there. So it's four Christmases. And it's just, you know, a crazy comedy movie. This is a funny movie, man. Another movie that came out in 2008 she was in was Lake City, which is a kind of drama thriller movie, suspense movie. You guys can read what this one's about. This one was a good one, I remember. And the latest movie that I have with Sissy Spacek, the last movie that I have to show you guys, is Deadfall. And Deadfall came out a couple years after that in 2012. And I haven't watched this one yet, but it looks pretty good. Looks like a sexy crime thriller. Just looks pretty crazy looking, man. You guys can read what it's about. Right there. results in a car accident and a dead state trooper on the run. Looks pretty good to me, man. This one looks good. But that was my Sissy Spacek movie collection. I have no idea why this took 20 minutes, probably because I have a lot of movies from her. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. And like I said, you can always click on... here, I'll show you. So if you guys don't know already, this is my channel right here, Spy Cat. Of course, the mouse is going to be all slow right now. And I've done a lot of these actor series. If you just go to my created playlists, I'm trying to look through the phone and do this, so that's why it's kind of being weird. But here we go. And I've done like 5 since then. So I've done about 80 different actors, if you can believe that. Cuba Gooding Jr. I mean, the list just goes on. So if you guys don't like the Sissy Spacek collection, there's got to be one actor who you can find on this 75 list of actors that I've done. And I probably got like 50 more to go. So I really want to get this done so I could organize my movies back in genre and show you guys like my updated horror collection and suspense collection, family, comedy, thriller, all those Western adventure. Can't wait to do those again. But yeah, just check these out if there's got to be an actor you might want to watch. And see you guys next time for the next actor, which will be Morgan Freeman.